My task today is to discuss with you the problem of epicardial scarring in the athlete. Ventricular arrhythmias and sudden cardiac death in individuals with an apparently normal heart may be the result, first of all, of concealed underlying structural abnormalities and or primary electrical heart diseases. This is a paper we published a few years ago, concerning our experience on sudden cardiac death in young people with an apparently normal heart. That means they die suddenly, but the autopsy was apparently negative. And you can see among 197 individuals, young individuals dying suddenly, gross postmortem examination identified a reliable cause of death in the majority of cases. But you can see here that 76 still remain unexplained after detailed examination of the heart. So after histologic evaluation of the myocardium and specified conduction tissue, we were able to identify more cases, subtle, concealed cases of sudden cardiac death, such as focal myocarditis, segmental cardiomyopathy, or conduction system disease that were unsuspected during life. And you can see here that 25% of those 76 remain unexplained. Some example of focal myocarditis without left ventricular dilatation or dysfunction or arrhythmias, as sudden death was the first sign of disease, and a case of unsuspected Lenegre disease, that is a conduction disease. And these young individuals had just a right bundle branch block on basal ECG that is deemed normal. So after macroscopic and histologic examination, we identify the majority of cases of structural anomaly underlying sudden death, but remain 6 cases of structural normal heart, probably due to channelopathies that are congenital, genetically determined condition that are not associated with structural anomaly and can predispose to ventricular fibrillation. But also we have to consider that a proportion of these ventricular arrhythmias and sudden cardiac death in patients with an apparently normal heart may be the result of uncompletely known structural abnormalities, structural subtests, along with low diagnostic sensitivity of currently available clinical tests. This is the case of non-ischemic left ventricular scarring. So in this today, I would like to discuss with you, to demonstrate that non-ischemic left ventricular scar is an important and emerging cause of sudden cardiac death in elite athletes. The first case I saw 10 years ago was this case. Look, he's a soccer player of Real Madrid, collapsed suddenly during an official game, and he recovered spontaneously from this event in September. Was a clear cardiac arrest, transient cardiac arrest, as you can see. So anyway, you recover spontaneously. So the event was defined and effort-induced syncope. So I was asked for the medical team of the Real Madrid to have a consultation for interpret the clinical findings in this athlete. You can see he was a 27-year-old professional soccer player without family history of sudden cardiac death cardiomyopathy, previously asymptomatic, and had this prolonged syncopal episode, effort related during a soccer game. So the ECG demonstrated T-wave inversion in the inferolateral leads, was a diffuse repolarization abnormality that was considered at that time as the sign of a sort of primary electrical disorder, channelopathies, because they were not able to identify a reliable structural cause of the syncope, of the event. Because the echo was completely normal. That means no global or segmental wall motion abnormalities, dysfunctions, but the contrast enhanced MRI showed this late gadolinium enhancement that was localized in the inferolateral wall and apical septum of the left ventricle. So there was just this late gadolinium enhancement that means myocardial fibrosis, very segmental, very localized in this region. So we perform a cascade family screening that was negative, and molecular genetics identified a plaque of filling II gene mutation variant that is debated as a pathogenic mutation. So I suggested to implant an ICD, because in my opinion, the syncope, therefore induced syncope, was arrhythmic in nature, and in my opinion, late gadolinium enhancement was a reliable structural substrate for this event. And the athlete, in my opinion, was at risk of relapses. And actually, after a few months, the medical doctor of Real Madrid called me because he continued to follow this individual. Of course, the athlete was not considered eligible for professional soccer, received beta blockers and was implanted in ICD. And you can see that after 32 months of follow-up during a leisure time tennis game, because it was not competitive anymore, experienced an appropriate ICD intervention of ventricular flutter, very frequent ventricular arrhythmia, that would have been fatal in the absence of ICD. So few years later, I was in Cadiz with Sanjay. Sanjay, you remember? And we received a notice that there was a sudden death during a competitive game in Italy. And this is the case of Morosini, who was a soccer player of A series of soccer. And he collapsed and died despite cardiopulmonary resuscitation and defibrillation. And the clinical pathologic features were reported in details by this paper and demonstrated no clinical evidence of heart disease. Of course, the athlete had undergone pre-participation screening, because in Italy it's compulsory. But the ECG was normal, the stress test was normal, and the echocardiography was normal. So it was considered eligible because there were no evidence of underlying structural heart disease. At the autopsy, there was a limited amount of, and distribution of the left ventricular myocardial fibrosis. That was an area of scarring the subepicardial, posterior septal, lateral left ventricular regions. The scar tissue measured 4 millimeters in thickness and 35 millimeters in length. So this was a very segmental, very limited region, area of fibrosis that account for the finding that the echo is normal. Because if you have a subepicardial scar, it's not transmural and it's not enough to induce a wall motion abnormalities in this region. So afterwards, there were a number of anecdotal cases and few series, like this reported a few weeks ago by is a multi-center study reporting 7 athletes with the subepicardial scar. All these athletes had repolarization abnormalities in inferolateral leads or arrhythmias with the right bundle branch block morphology, suggesting a subset in the left ventricle. And you can see here that during the follow-up, they were treated with beta blockers, and they have a relatively good, benign follow-up. This is not our experience. So this is an example of this paper, an athlete with repolarization abnormalities and effort-induced repetitive ventricular, premature ventricular beats with the right bundle branch block morphology and inferior axis, suggesting the origin from the posterior wall of the left ventricle. And you can see here demonstration of epicardia intramural, inferolateral scar. So the limitation of this study was that there was no comparison with controls to test the potential pathogenetic effect of the exercise in inducing this subepicardial lesion. So the studies with the contrast-enhanced MRI in athletes showed there are two patterns of late gadolinium enhancement in the left ventricle. One is the just discussed pattern of a stria pattern involving the inferolateral wall, the subepicardial with the subepicardial distribution. The other pattern, this is much more common, is the spot pattern, like this spot pattern, that is localized at the junction in the septum, at the junction with the right ventricle. Usually, this is the junctional points with the right ventricle, from the left and right ventricle. And this pattern, the second pattern of spot left gadolinium enhancement, is usually confined to the interventricular septum, commonly at the site of right ventricular attachment. And this late gadolinium enhancement pattern is very similar to that described in patients with pulmonary hypertension, in whom increased interventricular wall stress causes by right ventricular pressure overload may induce myocardial injury at this site. So this is a marker of pressure pulmonary hypertension. And the significant increase in pulmonary pressure demonstrated in highly trained athletes during intense exercise suggests a similar pathogenesis. So this spot late gadolinium pattern is considered a benign physiologic or paraphysiologic part of the athlete's heart, or the remodeling of the athlete's, of the heart to sustain training. So in the last decade, in our university, we collected a number of elite athletes with arrhythmias and left ventricular scarring, non-ischemic left ventricular scarring. And we prepared a manuscript with the result of this study. And the main objective of this study was to report the clinical imaging profile and the arrhythmia outcome of a cohort of 33 elite athletes with apparently idiopathic left ventricular arrhythmias and isolated non-ischemic late gadolinium enhancement at cardiac magnetic resonance. Of interest, the cardiac magnetic resonance features of this index athletic group were compared with the dose of cardiac magnetic resonance studies of control healthy athletes without ventricular arrhythmias in order to assess the relative prevalence of late gadolinium enhancement and to characterize the specific late gadolinium morphologic pattern of malignant arrhythmic scar, because we enroll athletes with all patterns of late gadolinium enhancement, either stria or spot. So the enrollment criteria were the frequent premature ventricular beats or ventricular tachycardia with a right bundle branch morphology, normal angiographic findings, and cardiac magnetic resonance evidence of isolated left ventricular scar with a non-ischemic pattern of post-contrast sequences not evaluated. This is an example of a 34-year-old basket player showing T-wave inversion in inferolateral leads and experiencing sustained ventricular tachycardia during a training session with a right bundle branch morphology and inferior axis. And the MRI showed this scarring, epicardial scarring in the left ventricle. So these are our results. It's interesting to see that this is the index group, and these are the control athletes. And you can see here that there was no evidence of global or segmental left ventricular dysfunction or right ventricular dysfunction in both groups. It's interesting that with regard to the type of predominant pattern, you can see a predominant pattern of scarring. 0% of control athletes had the stria pattern that was instead present in 76% of athletes with arrhythmias. And you can see that instead spot pattern was much more prevalent in athletes. What is interesting is that the echo was completely unremarkable. It was negative. Negative is negative, consistently negative, because the scar is not tumoral. And the right ventricle was also normal. What is interesting is this Kaplan-Meier analysis of the outcome. So you can see that athletes with late gadolinium enhancement with the junction of spot pattern didn't experience any events, arrhythmic events over the time. Instead, malignant, life-threatening ventricular arrhythmias and sudden cardiac death occurred exclusively, distinctly in those with an inferolateral striae pattern. So this is the pattern that is potentially associated with malignant arrhythmic events. This is another case of sudden cardiac death. It was a 39-year-old cyclist, professional old cyclist, and at the pre-participation screening, he showed no family history of sudden cardiac death. Cardiomyopathy was asymptomatic. The ECG alter showed frequent coupled premature ventricular beats with right bundle branch block morphology and superior axis. This is a typical pattern suggesting this kind of left ventricular scar. The ECG, once again, is normal. In the majority of cases, the ECG is not useful for raising the suspicion of this condition at pre-participation screening, because probably it's too much segmental, the lesion. And the echo was normal, but the MRI showed this scar in the inferolateral region of the left ventricle, a picardia scar, non-ischemic scar. So this scar was interpreted by the medical physician as a ill myocarditis that implied a benign scar. Is healed. So he had was considered eligible for competitive sport activity and died suddenly during a game. And this is a post-mortem demonstration of the scar in the left ventricle. You can see that the scarring tissue actually is a fibrofatty tissue that replaced the myocardium in the subepicardial, the epicardial level. And the molecular genetics, post-mortem molecular genetics, showed that desmosomal digenic heterozygosity for mutation desmoglein and desmocolin. So this was a scar that is a result of arrhythmogenic cardiomyopathy, desmosomal-related arrhythmogenic cardiomyopathy. And also in the family, we found two family members carrying desmocolin, just a single mutation with sign of scar in the left and right ventricle. So to conclude, we don't have evidence, we don't have enough information to demonstrate the pathogenesis of this non-ischemic left ventricle scarring. We can speculate, anyway, that this epicardial left ventricle scar is the result of a repair process of an inflammatory mediate left ventricle lesion due to the typical localization of the subepicardial, mediamural, non-subendocardial, like the ischemic scar, that in turn is the final common pathway of a number of pathogenetic conditions such as myocarditis, dilated cardiomyopathy, arrhythmogenic left ventricular cardiomyopathies, and sarcoidosis. All these conditions are induce a lesion that is inflammatory mediated and may account for the particular pattern of striae in the epicardial left ventricular wall. So, in conclusion, in athletes presenting with ventricular arrhythmias with right bundle branch block morphology, suggesting for a left ventricular origin, a normal ECG and 12-lead echocardiogram that are the routine examination performed at pre-participation screening, don't exclude the presence of an underlying potentially lethal arrhythmogenic subset. This is an important limitation of our current screening system. So left ventricular late gadolinium enhancement on contrast-enhanced cardiac interventions, mostly in the form of inferolateral striae, should be not dismissed as a benign sign of ill myocarditis, because it may represent a marker of a genetic cardiomyopathic post-inflammatory cardiomyopathy at risk of sudden cardiac death during sports. Thank you for your attention.